Hey, what's going on, everyone? In today's video, I'll be showing you how to properly export and get the file type that you need and everything in Final Cut Pro X. So it's actually very simple, and the options are actually pretty basic as well. So we're all done with our project, so let's go ahead and export it. So we want to just go to File, Share, and now you see a list of default presets for exporting your video. So you can either have it on a standard definition DVD, a master file, which is just, I guess, the most default way you can do it. Apple devices, so either 720p or 1080p. Facebook, all three of these are exporting it and uploading it directly to these websites. So Facebook, you can log into your account and it'll save it. YouTube, as you can see, I already have it logged in and saved my gaming channel on there. And also Vimeo. And now these are my this 1080p and 720p are my own presets that I made, so and you can make your own as well. Now this save current frame, if you want to just take a snapshot of this frame or whatever frame is showing right now, you can just do that, and basically it saves it to wherever you want. Or we can go to add destination. Now an easier way to save the current frame is just going right down here, or also sharing your project is, you can just do it right here, this little arrow. It's pretty simple, but either way, you'll get the same results if you choose this or go to File, Share. So let's go ahead and do Add Destination so we can see all of the different options. So we can add a destination for like a Blu-ray, if in case you didn't want a DVD. Let's say DVDs are outdated, so we want Blu-ray. Add it right up there. We can have it compressed so we can properly email it, or CNNI report. I mean, they have some of the common places that you can export video to, or you can do an HTTP live stream of it. And if you have compressor, you can choose that option as well. So let's just go ahead and do just a regular 1080p. I already have this all set up. I actually got it from the Apple devices 1080p. I believe I just copied that. So we can just do the Apple devices 1080p. So format, Apple devices, H.264 if you either want a faster export or better quality. We'll choose better quality. Resolution, of course, we want 1080p. And if we want to add to a playlist, so if you have folders in iTunes or playlists in iTunes, we can do that. We're not going to do that. So let's go ahead and do that. Can go ahead and exit out of that. I'm just going to go to File, Share, because I'm just used to that. And basically here are the exporting settings. So we can go to settings again, we can just confirm everything looks good. And I do recommend confirming that everything is good, even if you do this multiple times per day. Just make sure all the settings are good before you export it. You don't want to re-export it after you find out that it's bad. So we can go back to info, we can title it, add a description, and also have tags, because Finder now supports tags, so we can do that. I don't think I'm going to do that. Let's just do next. And also make sure all the settings down here are good too. So next, we'll just save this to the desktop and call it cats. Save. And now it is exporting. As you can see right in the middle here, this is where you're going to see the exporting progress. So it's just about done. This is just a 40-second clip. Now it's going to automatically open up QuickTime Player so you can watch it just to be sure it's all good. So that's basically it for this video. If you have any questions about exporting, go ahead and leave them in the comments section below. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.